Adults. Joining us this morning is Dr. William Lawson with the Department of Psychiatry and Behavioral Sciences at Howard University College of Medicine. Dr. Lawson, we appreciate you coming in today.
Thank you very much.
I want to ask you first, you know, we've all been watching and getting this information coming out of Connecticut, and we talk a lot about how kids deal with it, but on some level, the adults have to deal with it first, and we go through this range of emotions, crying, anger, all these sorts of things. Is that okay, I guess, is the way to start that question. Is that appropriate for adults?
Yes, it is. Being able to deal with these feelings, to express them, is quite fine. The important thing is that this is also a wonderful time that folks can pull together with their families and talk about these kinds of issues and put them into perspective.
So you don't want to hold it in?
No, you don't have to hold it in.
The one thing that I've seen, you know, just being glued to the set and hearing so many different analysts and psychiatrists talk about it, is that when it comes to your feelings as an adult, as a parent, it is really important to really have a grasp of them before you try to have this conversation with your children. Would you say that is an important...
I think that's a good idea. To be able to come in as an adult is someone who can serve as a support system for the child. And also it helps the adult to recognize that we're now helping someone else. And it helps each other too. When we're focusing on our own inner feelings of pain, anguish, it's not as helpful as going out and recognizing that we can help other people dealing with theirs and being support systems for them.
So when you get to the point where you have to deal with children, what's the appropriate way to get into that? Do you wait for your child to express either some feeling or some behavior that says now's time to get into some sort of a conversation?
You can start talking right away about the events that's having turned your perspective. It wouldn't go into detail unless the child brings it up. But at the same time, if the child is in distress, you can help them to understand why they may be distressed. They may not know what's going on. You can put some perspective for them so they can then do what they can to get the support and comfort that they need.
Okay. Warning signs. What are some things to look for in your child?
The main thing is persisting feelings. One of the big concerns, of course, is school anxiety. Mm-hmm. So, you know, if you go to schools, it's a bad thing to do. Just like people develop sometimes irrational fears about hospital because someone died there. It's important to let them know that school is a very, very safe place. The other is persisting nightmares, persisting feelings of distress, persisting despondency. Kids do not have the apparatus that we do to express depression and anxiety. They sometimes become more hyperactive, or they may get into difficulty with their classmates.
Okay. All right. Dr. William Lawson with Howard University College of Medicine. We appreciate your perspective on this, and thanks for helping to give us some tools to start moving forward as a nation, really, to deal with this.
Thank you very much.